Yes, you know what time it is. BBTV time. Got Curtis Gargano with me, the main man. You know the one.
Yes, British boxers, boys. You know where it's at. We're back.
Well, tell us where we are.
We're at Stubbs' gym now. We're based here now, you know. Top gym. We've got two rings, as you can see. We've got all top quality bags, loads of space. Everything we need in this gym. Everything we need.
So you moved over here from Rochdale?
Over there. We was with Mick Mulcahy. We was renting there. And then we've moved on now. Wish Mick all the best. You know, he's doing it. He's doing his own thing there now. But Gargano Boxing is based here now. Right. With my old friend, Stubby.
When you're getting the radiators put in, mate?
Speak to Stubby. He's got that big jet thing there. Look, if you can see it. You can see that big jet there.
Yeah.
Straight from Manchester Airport.
Boom.
John Spencer's nicked it from Manchester Airport.
Oh, come on, boy. Give me a little roundup of your boys. Come on.
Yeah, here you've got Dean Wilkinson.
I know Dean.
These boys are waiting in today. Yeah. Dean Wilkinson, you know, started his career on the road. Very talented lad, gifted. He's having his fourth pro fight tomorrow night in Sheffield.
Nice.
And then we've got the main man here, John Spencer, who looks like he's going to cry. Because he's making weight. He's weighing at 12, mate. He's having his third pro fight tomorrow. He did a six-rounder with the talented, what's his name now? Who did you box last week?
Liam Gaynor.
He boxed Liam Gaynor last week. Yeah. Good fight. Good he's in with a top kid tomorrow. He's had 9 fights, I think, hasn't he? But yeah, John's going to be a busy man next year.
Well, like about these boys is, I ask them who they're fighting, where they're fighting, they don't know.
They just
listen, wherever Curtis tells us to fight.
Curtis is the man.
So, how are you finding making weight at the minute then?
Not too bad, yeah.
Yeah.
Fair enough. We're busy all the time anyway, so.
Trains hard, long ones, each helper.
Yeah.
Does it right.
Good man. Last time I seen Dean, he was in the opposite corner of someone who was bashing me up in the ring.
On that little chat. Do you remember that was a good one?
I still got my ribs still hurt from that. Mate, you're basically on the road with Curtis.
On the road with Curtis now, yeah. It's been a while. Should have turned over me years ago, but didn't. Curtis came to me about 7 years ago to tell me to turn over with him, but just didn't have the confidence to do it back then. But brought me on board over the last 2 years. Been training with him now for the last 18 months, 24 months, and he's putting the graft in with me, so he's making me the fighter I am now, so that's a good thing.
Are you all enjoying it?
Loving 100%. It, yeah.
Up and down the country, you know, next year's going to be busy. Like you say, these lads are learning. Like, he's had no amateur fights, but he's a very talented lad, but he's learning every fight, you know.
Yeah. You've always been able to box, haven't you? I mean,
I've always been in and around, yeah. No amateur fights, so, you know, it means everything, doesn't it, to people if I've had amateur fights, but I'm here to fight.
It's like with Dean, we know he works, he's got family and all, he's got commitments, he does his PTs as well. You know, he's got a lot going on in his life, but one thing about Dean is an athlete, trains hard. You go in his stories, he's always training, he must train 2 to 3 times a day. Comes in here, gets his sparring, he eats healthy, you know, he lives a good life, doesn't drink, you know, he doesn't have the party life, he's a family man. John, I've been on him, I've told him, now look, you're in the pro game now, you've got to up your game, you know, it's not like the unlicensed now, or he comes from MMA and bare knuckle background, you know, he had about over 300 fights doing that, but it's nothing like that now. He's got to step his game, he's got to train every day, sometimes twice a day, he's got to make the weight, he's got to do things up. Properly, he's got to up his game. So I've been tracking his runs because he lives far away, John. He gets 2 buses and he has to walk 20 to 30 minutes as well. So it's like a 2-3 hours to get here sometimes with the traffic.
But he's in the gym. That's good dedication, then, isn't it? Yeah,
he's in the gym. He knows he's got to earn his money. You know, people think they can just you know, not train and cheat the game. But if you've got a long career on the road, you've got to train hard. And I can't be there to wipe their bums all the time. They've got to do it.
I feel the improvement as well since being with you. Do you know what I mean? I do feel a big improvement.
I mean, he had a tough fight for his first fight, you know, but he's learned a hell of a lot off that. So, you know, he's got 3 more fights. But is it 3 or 2?
Yeah, 3.
2.
No, three more.
No, you've got 2 more. Well, he's got 3 more fights booked in. I'm going to tick every one of them off. You know, he's going to be a top English. No, the English journeyman is a dying breed. There's not many now. Do you know what I mean? So, you know.
Why is that?
I don't know. You know, I'm hoping that people are going to see that it's good to fight on the road. The last 3 lads I've signed up have come from amateurs. You know, these lads have come from unlicensed. You know, but they work double hard. I mean, the level's going to go, the tier's going to go higher because, you know, people are seeing me now and, you know, people are a part of it now. You know, I'm working with a lot of other gyms, amateur gyms now. Loads of it. I'm working with people in Liverpool, people everywhere now. You know, I'm willing to work with anyone. You know, if they come to me and say they've got fighters, you can't sell tickets, what, going, oh, I'll manage them and get them fights. You just train them and, you know, make sure they're right. But yeah, there's only better fighters coming through and I'm hoping now, you know, people see us doing what we're doing, that people are going to know it's cool to go on the road. People are embarrassed to go on the road, but they don't understand it. To go on the road, you know, you're getting in with different levels of kids every week and you need to have your own gears. Like people say, when you box at a top level, like a British level or a world level, you know, you see these top fighters like Terence Crawford, they're up the gears, so you've got to have gears to match them. Some of them can't, they get stopped. It's like these boys, when you get in the ring and you're with top, depends what level of fight you're in with, you've got to up the gears to keep up with them and not get stopped. You know, slow them down. Do what you gotta do. These guys are learning on the road. I always say when you get to 20 fights, 15, 20 fights, if you get to there without getting stopped too many times or even don't get stopped like Sheamus, you know, you're gonna do well.
Yeah, man, defo. And Sheamus has been warming up there for a bit. Should we go and speak to Sheamus as well? Yeah.
Sheamus.
Sorry if the camera's shaking, everyone. It's just that I'm a bit
the
cold.
The Celtic Cobra, he loves being on camera.
Yeah.
He loves it.
Here we go, the Celtic Cobra.
How you doing, mate?
All right, mate. Yeah, so you've been racking up the fights, haven't you?
I have indeed, mate. I have indeed.
Tell us a little bit about, you know, your journey so far.
Well, yeah, like I say, I made my debut at the end of July. That was my debut. I fought a good strong kid at super middleweight, Leon Willings. From there, I've just been on a crest of a wave, mate. I haven't stopped and I've had 15 in 17 weeks and I've got two more to finish the year strong.
15 and 17 weeks, that must make you one of the most active fighters in the country.
Got to be up there.
You've got to be.
It's got to be up there. 2022 is going to get even busier, mate.
Yeah, and you've been in with some good kids.
Yeah, some top kids, top ex-amateurs, good amateur pedigree. Some of the lads I think will go all the way domestically. There's some good lads on my resume, so yeah.
Where did I see you at? Did you fight Jake Andrews recently?
I did indeed, mate.
Yeah, that was a good atmosphere, Oldham.
It was booming. It was top of the card, mate. It was absolutely booming. Great atmosphere, great crowd.
And you know, with Sheamus, if you watch, there's not one person. He's boxed in Bournemouth, Plymouth, Scotland. He's been all over. The only place he's not been is Ireland, but we'll get there soon, we'll lad. But what I'm saying, yeah, he's always in top shape, yeah. He's always in top shape, and every one of his fights are competitive. Even though the scorecards don't say it, you've seen his fight with Jake Andrews.
Yeah.
He fought back. Yeah. He fights back. He doesn't just come here and put his hands up and survive. He does fight back. And the crowd enjoy him.
Yeah.
You know, he's a top. What he's done is in the past 5 months is unreal.
And you're fighting again tomorrow, aren't you?
He loves it.
I'm not next week, mate.
Tell us about the show.
Comes all the way from Burnley, what's it called? Paddy. In Burnley. He trains so hard. You know, it's good for these other lads in the gym to see how hard he works and what he's getting back off boxing is unreal.
No doubt.
He deserves it.
What show's this next week?
I'm fighting a lad called Thomas Rafferty. I think, where is it?
Oh, yeah. Show.
It's on a Black Flash show, Manchester. Victoria. Yeah, that's correct, mate. That's the one, yeah. I'm fighting Thomas Rafferty. Good kid. He's had a good amateur pedigree. Decent boxer. Gets behind his jab well. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it, mate.
Yeah, brilliant, man, brilliant. So, I mean, it's like, it's an interesting thing you said there about the English journeyman. There's a lot at the minute because of the restrictions and stuff where foreign journeymen are coming over, but then they're getting flights cancelled at last minute and everything.
Do you know what I respect?
Do you think we should invest more in UK?
Yeah, definitely.
Give more opportunities to UK.
Yeah, because we've got to look at how the boxing is going to be in the future because everything's changing, life's changing. It's not 5 years ago. Everything's just changing in life. Listen, I've got to just respect anyone involved with boxing in the past 6 months, the board members, the promoters, the matchmakers. You know, my phone's not stopped going. But, you know, everybody's been getting the lads out. These shows have been happening. I mean, there's been some shows now, what, there have been 10 shows on to 15 shows, I think, sometimes, and they've all happened. There's not been many shows been cancelled, but I respect all the foreign journeymen because they know when they come in, they don't get stopped and they give a good account of themselves. They can come back.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So it does hurt when I see him get stopped. It hurts me. I'm gutted. Do you know what I mean? But it is what it is. Things will get better. Everyone's working hard behind the scenes in boxing. You know, everyone involved with boxing. I hope you all have a good Christmas because I know how hard everyone's worked.
Yeah.
Behind the scenes. Everyone. Yeah. Even you.
Now, we're meant to be waiting for Scott Williams here, but he's not turned up, has he? So we've got to put that on camera here so we know.
Yeah,
so man. It's on record.
Scott's a bum. And that's it, a bomb.
All right, boys, listen.
But yeah, it's quiet. What I'm saying is, before you go, it's quiet. So quiet today in the gym because, you know, Steve Jackson's been a busy, busy boxer. Steve Jackson's got one of the best, busiest journeymen in the country at the minute. He's been in with some top dogs. It's a shame he's not here. You know, Levi Dunn started his career on the road. He wanted to win. He's had it tough. Do you know what I mean? It's, every lad in this gym has been doing well for boxing, you know, so got to say well done to everyone.
Amen. Good luck with all the fights coming up, boys.
Thank you, my man.
Anyone want to say anything else?
Respect to you, BBB TV.
BBB TV, yeah.
Let's go, champ. Let's go, champ. Yeah, go on. Yeah. I'm sending messages out to you boxers at home, you part-timers, you think you're a boxer on Instagram when you're not. The real boxers are here in the gym.